We're fully supportive of decision 21.1, and I'm genuinely looking forward to a ceremony which will award the freedom of the bar to such deserving individuals. If I could offer some brief comment, Mr. Mayor, I'm afraid I do not know Mr. Rossi, except by reputation. I'm quite certain that he's a worthy recipient of freedom of the bar. These have been, and I'm afraid will continue to be, difficult times. So Mr. Rossi's work in promoting community peace and tolerance is well deserving of the award of the freedom of the bar. With regard to Janet and Jim Gill, can I say that I'm pleased the council has chosen to avoid causing the amount of strife by awarding the freedom of the bar to them both at the same time. They are both thoroughly deserving of the honour, being at the same time long-serving councillors, quite exceptional mayors, and in my opinion, genuinely nice people. It was a real pleasure to speak with them before or after council meetings, seldom during, I'm afraid, and they never seem to have an unkind word to say about anyone. I'll even forgive Jim for returning to the council simply to remove the Conservative councillors who crept into the people of Fair Award in 2006. His personal popularity, which is a mark of the man, made him extremely hard to stand against the way in terms of our candidates. Which leads me to my friend and colleague, who's richly deserving of this honour, Dermot Boston. Despite his cancer, Dermot remains such a positive person, and while I feel some disappointment for him, he was never able to be mayor. When I spoke to him today, he was genuinely delighted at the possibility of receiving such an honour from the council, where he served for so many years. Aside from losing his sense of humour from the council when he stepped down in 2014, we lost the voice of the last person who could, and maybe did say, "Well, I was in charge of leisure services." The last Conservative councillor who actually served in the Greenwich Council administration run by our party. So, Mr. Mayor, while I have much to say about Dermot, I think I'll say it another time, but simply to comment that he is deserving of the honour, and I'm extremely grateful to councillors of all parties for agreeing to confer him on him. This leaves one last person with whom I tangled regularly across this chamber, Chris Roberts. Now, obviously, there will be people in this chamber who struggle to get through their thick skulls that Chris deserves this honour. I apologise for that, I could not get it. But despite the controversy he often attracted, I'm happy to support this nomination. Nothing more hated, and I know there are probably people from both groups in this chamber tonight, Chris had a vision for the borough. I'm not saying it all worked or that I agree with it all, but the improvements in transport, the delivery Olympics, and the confirmment of your statements, all of which are in the report, are clearly substantial achievements. On a personal level, I've said on numerous occasions, on the serious issues which face this bar, on the occasions when I was in the opposition, he was generous this time, and we always call if he wouldn't seem serious enough, but we should try and secure opposition agreement as well as the Labour Party thoughts on this issue. I also found him disarming in his honesty on occasions, I have to say most especially in private. On one occasion, I have to say, I still remember fondly when he informed me that he was going to propose to Cabinet that he split their salaries into two groups, those that deserved more money and those that didn't. I laughed at him and said, good luck with that. And the next time I saw him, he very generously laughed and said that he had been, in fact, in a minority of one in that discussion. And so maybe I did have some advice for him after all. It might be interesting, undoubtedly, sat at Captain Labour Ventures while he was on the council, and maybe this honour is due for him on that basis as well. Anyway, so I want to conclude my thoughts by offering my thanks to Labour members of the council for conferring the honour of being involved on Dermot as a Conservative, and on the others, I have to say, my popular mother, who Janet and Jim, for their long service to the bar. I'm genuinely looking forward to the ceremony where we can celebrate all of these individual services to the bar.
Thank you so much, Councillor Drury, and I'm very happy if you wish to propose it, I'm very happy to send it. But on behalf of, I think now, everybody in the chamber, we have five people here who will receive the highest honour that the borough can give. It will be a wonderful occasion, and everybody will be able to go forward and speak about any of the five that they wish to, obviously, in terms of proposing the freedom of the borough. They are worthy candidates. You said you didn't know Dr. Tariqa Bassi very well, and I think what we've done is, in that short synopsis there, try to get across exactly what you said about, you know, the prevent agenda, anti-radicalisation, fact that he very bravely went to the High Court to make sure that he could get the radicals out. And I have to say that Greenwich Islamic Centre for all that they've done for us in terms of, you know, when we had disturbances in 2011, when we had the murder of Lee Rigby and all of that, the tragic death of Lee Rigby, that actually our multi-faith community has stood by us and we are the richer borough for it. I think we leave